Good day, everyone. My courtesy to our dearest professor, Ma'am Nerissa Beatrice, and to my fellow classmates, a pleasant day to all of you. Today, I was assigned to discuss the topic, growth and development during adolescence. Now, let me introduce you the concept of adolescence. So what is adolescence? Adolescence is a period of life of an individual when society no longer views you as a child but does not recognize you as an adult. It is a transition between childhood and adulthood. So sa stage na to, ito yung moment na nag-accelerate yung different changes for young people. So dito natin maiintindihan kung ano man yung mga nangyayari sa kanila. Syempre tayo as a teacher, napagdaanan na natin. So, alam na natin yung mga gagawin sa mga estudyante natin na nakaka-experience nito. So, adolescent is one of the most interesting part of our journey as a person. So, let's talk about the adolescent development. So, adolescent development, it is an enormous transition. It is about the physical, cognitive, emotional, social, morals, and values. So, they say that adolescence is a time for enormous transition. So, ito yung period of great potential sa mga young people to engage more deeply with the world around them. So, in this lesson, we will talk about the major development changes that occur in adolescence, especially in the physical. We will talk about the hormonal changes and development. In cognitive, it is the changes in the way the brain functions, and in emotional, it is how adolescents process emotions and stress. About the social, it is about the changes in familial, social, and romantic relationships. And in moral values, it is how adolescents regard their place in the world. So these are the aspects of growth and development during adolescence. So let's talk about it one by one. So the focus of this study. The focus of this study is about the changes that are normal and necessary part of adolescent. Number two, the different ways that the adolescent experience. Number three, how adult can support adolescent's growth and development. So, I hope that at the end of these lessons, we can inculcate all the learnings about this topic. So, we have the different areas of adolescent development. So, alam naman natin na hindi lang tayo dapat mag-focus dun sa physical aspect ng isang adolescent. Ito yung mga areas of development wherein we must understand that there are different areas. Kaya nga, sinasabi natin na teenagers also experience changes in cognitive, emotional, social, and moral aspects. So, we will talk about first, the physical development. So, the physical development is about the changes that occur both inside and outside the body during adolescence. It happened through the process called puberty. So, in this aspect, we will talk about the hormonal changes that happen during adolescence. So, the changes that occur both inside and outside is what we call puberty. So, puberty is a long process and it includes many physical and emotional changes. So, puberty, it is the actual changes that happen in our body. So, ang puberty po, nangyayari siya gradually. So, paunti-unti nila itong na-experience, hindi ito nangyayari overnight. So, na pagising mo, nasa adolescent stage ka na. So, you will always go through what we call process. So, what is puberty? Puberty is about the rapid skeletal and sexual maturation. It occurs 2 years earlier for girls than boys. So, the puberty, the age from puberty differs from male to female, from different age group, and from different person. So, sa mga babae, puberty begins at the range of 8 to 13 years old, and sa mga lalaki naman, it ranges from the age of 10 to 15 in boys. So, what is testosterone? So, testosterone is the genital development, height, weight changes, voice changes. So, dito, nangyayari about sa mga boys siya, and yung estrogen naman is about the breast, uterine, and skeletal development. So, yung testosterone po, yan yung primary hormones ng mga lalaki na may pinakamalaking role sa pag-develop ng mga male reproductive tissues. And yung estrogen naman, ito yung hormone for women na responsible for reproductive and female characteristics. So, ito yung hormones na capable for reproductions. So, physical development. Physical changes in adolescents shift from their childhood bodies to their adult bodies and give them the ability to get pregnant. This ability to get pregnant or cause pregnancy is called fertility. So, in this aspects, adolescents are trying to figure out their sexual values. So, dito, sa part na to, makikurious yung mga adolescents. They will ask different questions about their sex. So, here, let's talk about the different changes in female and male. So, females will see changes where fats appear their body, breasts become fuller, and hips become wider. They typically experience first menstruation during adolescent. And sa mga male naman, male shoulders become broader and their muscles get bigger. The penis and testes cells also grow. They will begin to experience erections and ejaculations. Their voices also deepen during this time. So, we have the sequence of pubertal events in girls. First, so growth, fat mass greater, hips rounding out, widen. Skin becomes oily, all permanent teeth erupt, and increase in perspiration. So sa dito nararanasan nila yung different sequence or changes sa mga babae. And we also have what we call telarche or the breast development. So sa telarche, during puberty, the female's breast starts to develop and their hips become wider. And here in puberty, we will also have the genital hair. So females starts to develop their hair in their armpit and their public area. Pubic area, I mean. And here is the menarche, the menstruation begins. Ito yung first menstruational breathing. Ito yung sign na fertile ng isang babae. And here we also have sequence of pubertal events in boys. So growth, muscle mass greater, shoulders widen, skin becomes oily, all permanent teeth erupt, increase in perspiration, and testes and penis increases in size, larynx enlarges, voice deepens. And meron din silang tinatawag na puberty or genital hair. Male also develops hair in their armpit and pubic area, pero yung ibang males, they have hair in face and chest. And we also have this what we call mustache or facial hair growth, and they also have nocturnal emissions or the spontaneous erections and ejaculations occur at night, or is what we call wet dreams. So when male ejaculate and release sperm, this is what we call orgasm during sleep. So the common adolescent concerns of body image. So sometimes our adolescents feel anxious about their appearance. So they ask this question, how do I look? Am I normal? Can I become more beautiful or smart? Are food supplements needed for bodybuilding? Height increase measures? They also have cosmetic surgery. So sa time ng mga adolescents, they are anxious about their appearance. Sometimes they may feel self-conscious. Minsan nag-worry sila na baka they don't fit in. Na kapag hindi sila maging katulad ng iba, so yun mga concern ng mga adolescent. And this, we will talk about the influences on timing of puberty. So, we will talk about the genetics. So, genetics and environment. So, genetics, a person's genetic makeup can affect the timing of puberty and what the changes look like. So, yung genetics or yung genes natin, they may pass from generation to generation. So, yung genetics natin have strong influence in the puberty. And environment naman natin, one of the factor is the nutrition and health, quality of family relationships. So, sa environment naman natin, yung lifestyle factors, including nutrition, can affect the puberty. So, these are the influences of timing of puberty, the genetic and the environment. So, these factors can affect the growth and development of our adolescents. So, what can adults do? Let adolescents know that they are going through is normal. So, let us understand na lahat ng na-experience nila, ipapaintindi natin sa kanila yung mga developmental path na yon ay normal lang na nangyayari. Next, encourage adolescents to have a positive view of their bodies. So, alam naman natin na yung bodies natin varies from person to person. So, may maliit, may malaki, meron ding mababa, ganyan. So, kailangan as an adult, let's help our adolescents to appreciate their own bodies and development. Let's get active with adolescents. Help adolescents eat well. Teach adolescents to avoid drugs. Make sure adolescents get enough sleep. So yan yung mga gagawin ng mga adults to guide our students, to guide our adolescents and teenagers. So ito yung mga things na kailangan natin as a parent, maging isa tayong role model in which we can help our students to monitor our progress. Now, let's talk about the cognitive development of our adolescents. So, the cognitive development refers to the changes in brain that prepare people to think and learn. According to John Piaget, adolescents are in the formal operational stage. So, in this aspect, adolescents develop more advanced reasoning skills and they also develop the ability to think abstractly. So, yan yung cognitive development natin na nangyayari. So, alam naman natin na abstract thinking means thinking about the things around and can be seen, heard, or touch. So, ito yung tinatawag na formal operational stage. So, what is formal operational stage? They use this reasoning to think about how reality compares to ideals, think hypothetically about different choices and consequences, plan how to pursue goals, think about the minds of others, including what do they think of me. So, dito sa formal operational stage, 'di ba? They think about reality compared to ideas. So meron silang connections between sa mga iniisip nila and nangyayari na sa paligid nila. And they think about hypothetically about their choices and consequences. So ginagamit nila yung mga logical thinking nila wherein kung ano man yung mga choices and consequences ng actions nila, they make sure that they are responsible. And how to pursue goals? So they improve their future thinking capacity. So, kung ano man yung long-term and short-term goals nila, kung ano ba yung kanilang priorities, they make sure na planado po yung lahat. So, ito namang what do they think of me mindset. So, dito, concerned sila or conscious sila kung ano man ang iniisip ng iba tungkol sa kanila. So, that is what we call the formal operational stage ng isang adolescent. So, adolescents, we also have adolescent egocentrism. So, describe the state common to most teenagers in which they seem to believe the world revolves around them. So, it talks about the constant focus of others' attention. So, pag sinabi nating egocentrism, so meron silang focus, constant focus of others' attention. So, yung mga egocentrism, meron tinatawag na excessive interest in oneself. So, sometimes concerned sila sa welfare mo. So, kapag adolescent ka na, you tend to focus others' opinions about you, and sometimes, yun ang pinaliniwalaan mo. So, there are different types of adolescent egocentrism. So, first is the imaginary audience. Everyone is watching. So, sa imaginary audience, they tend to believe that there are people who are always watching. So, dito, mas magiging self-conscious ka. O, magiging self-conscious ang isang teenager kasi akala mo laging may matang nakatingin sa'yo. So, kaya sinasabi natin ditong imaginary audience. We also have personal fable or belief that he or she is unique. So, personal fable, they tend to believe that no one else has ever experienced similar feelings or emotions. Kaya yung mga adolescents, mas magiging dramatic sila in terms of describing things. So, minsan, na sinasabi nila na yung mga phrases na hindi mo ko maiintindihan. So, ganon yung mga phrases nila. So, they develop skills to understand others' thoughts and feelings. And next is what we call hypocrisy. So, dito sinasabi nila na it's okay for one to do it, but not the other. So, in this behavior of people, the behavior of people who do things that they tell other people not to do. So, yung mga actions nila nagko-contradict sa mga sinasabi nila. And that is what we call hypocrisy. And next is the pseudo-stupidity. This is what we call the use of oversimplified logic. So, adolescents fail to see the obvious, not because it's too hard, but because they make simple tasks more complicated than it is. So, it is what we call the pseudo-stupidity. So, how this changes affect adolescents? So, ito yung how do these changes affect adolescents? First is the heightened self-consciousness. Beliefs no one else has experienced feelings or emotions tend to become cause-oriented, tend to exhibit a justice orientation. So, ito yung mga characteristics na pwedeng maka-apekto sa behavior ng and cognitive development ng isang adolescent. So, next, we will talk about the emotional development. So, emotional development is Erikson identity versus role confusion. So, sa mga teenagers, ito yung mga nangyayari sa kanila, identity versus role confusion. Identity, adolescents have problems answering who am I, and sa role confusion naman occurs when adolescents are unsure of where they are going and who they are. Where do I belong? So, sa sabi ni Erik Erikson, adolescents are now in the stage of role confusion. So, the searching for identity is really important. So, sa theory ni Erikson, kailangan yung adolescent magkaroon tayo ng identity formation. So, sometimes, finding one's identity can be challenging. pero it can motivate adolescents to learn about themselves and more confident in their own unique identity. So, how do these changes affect teens? So, kapag hindi po na ano yung identity versus role confusion, magkakaroon po tayo ng tinatawag na rebellion. So, rebellion, replay of phallic issues, it is more emotionally changed than acts such as staying out late, wearing clothing which is not approved by parents, or having tattoos and body piercing. So, ito lamang yung isa sa mga examples na mangyayari kapag hindi po nila na meet yung tinatawag nilang identity versus role confusion. So, nangyayari ang rebellion kapag ang isang adolescent ay na-fail sa paghanap ng identity niya. Sometimes, yung adolescents magiging attention seeker, they oppose values and norms. So, yan yung mga changes na that affect our teens. So, how parents can support emotional development? So, paano ba natin masusuportahan yung emotional development ng isang teenager? So, first, make your own emotional well-being a priority. So, adolescents need to recognize their emotions, strength, and weaknesses. So, kailangan i-consider natin yung feelings ng iba para mas maintindihan mo yung certain situation. Number two is practice healthy goal setting. So, it helps the adolescents to focus and promote sense of mastery. Kung ano man yung mga smaller tasks and goals, kailangan na ma-manage ng maayos. Number three, value every adolescent's unique identity. So, kailangan all identities are equally valued in the society. Number four, resolve conflicts with respect for others. So, kapag meron tayong mga conflicts, the adolescent must focus on resolving the issue instead of blaming others. And number five, manage your anger. So, sa pag support ng emotional development ng isang bata, we have to manage our anger. So, in managing our anger, you may think first before you speak. So, kailangan kalmado ka lang and kung maaari, you can use humor to release tension. So, that's all about the support of emotional development ng ating mga estudyante. So, next, we have the social development. So, what is social development? So, as a general rule, when parent-child relationship had been good before adolescent, they continued to be relatively smooth during adolescent. Relationship with friends and peers become increasingly more important. So, sa social development natin, it refers about the process in which a child learns to interact with others around them. So, kailangan meron din silang interaction between others. So, sa social development, kapag na-establish ng maayos yung social development, the adolescent will find it easier to establish a good relationship. So, kapag nagkaroon tayo ng naka-establish tayo nito. So, Eric's social stages in the minds of adolescents. Pag na-establish natin yung, di ba, nandito tayo sa identity versus role confusion stage. So, the adolescents have ideally just finished working through the tension of competence versus inferiority. And they are ready after the intimacy versus isolation. So, dito, sa intimacy, this is where the deep relationship can be formed. So, dito, natututunan at na-develop natin kung paano ma-establish ang intimate relationship. So, kapag na-fail sila, it would lead to isolation. So, social development, mahalaga rin ang tinatawag nating team play. So, adolescent seek group and or team activities. So, ano ba yung benefits of team play? Work towards team group goals, learns that intellectual demands are greater, assumes greater social responsibility, and learns how to fail and to succeed. So, making team activities are necessary. The adolescent tend to seek opportunities to engage others. So, because of team play, adolescents develop the importance of teamwork and collaboration. So, paano ba natin madidevelop ang isang ganitong activities? So, how parents can support social development? Number one is set examples of healthy relationships. So, the role of our parents or family is very important. They should be a role model in building healthy relationship with others. So, number two is monitor and get to know their friends and dating partners. So, kailangan as parents, alam mo kung sino yung mga friends nila, whom they spend time with, and what they are doing, where are they going. So, with that, you can monitor them properly and guide them. Next, encourage participation in activities they care about. So, we must help them to make friends by getting them involved in activities that match their interest. And number four, exhibit empathic behavior. So, dito, ipapakita yung concern with other people. And next, we will talk about the moral development of our adolescent. So, moral development during adolescent, children develop the ability to understand abstract ideas. Moral development prevents them from acting on unchecked urges instead of considering what is right for society and good for others. So, sa adolescent stage na to, we have gradual formation of the concept of right and wrong. So, kailangan yung behavior mo is socially acceptable or in accordance with the social values and norms. So, yun yung tinatawag nating moral development. So, how parents can support moral development. So, number one, talk honestly and openly about your values. Support them in evaluating and addressing the results of their actions. Number three, listen but don't judge. So, let's talk about it one by one. So, talk honestly and openly about your values. So, kapag merong open and honest communication, mas mabibuild mo yung trust sa bawat isa and mas magkakaroon ka ng mutual understanding and respect. Number two, support them in evaluating their actions. So, as a parent, we need to evaluate the actions and decisions of our children. So, kapag may mga negative outcomes, we can help them to think of new ways or approach in solving their problem. And number three, listen but don't judge. So, when adolescents share their concerns, they are making themselves vulnerable to your opinion. So, listen to them, give them advice, and make them feel safe. So, that's all. So, thank you for listening. Sana mas marami po kayong natutunan sa ating lessons. Thank you and have a good day.